Hey everyone, Justin here. If I asked you to picture a scientist, what comes to mind? Do you think of someone in a lab coat working with beakers full of bubbling chemicals? Or maybe someone sitting outside looking at the stars in a huge telescope? What makes someone a scientist? Is it the fact that they know how to use all these powerful tools? Or is there something more to it? Well, today we're gonna find out. By the end of this lesson, you'll be able to recognize how scientific thinking helps us solve problems, use objective observations to gather evidence, and explain the importance of collaborating with other scientists. Let's get into it. In our last lesson, we learned that science is the way we ask and answer questions about our world by collecting, testing, and using evidence. So, what does that make a scientist? A scientist is someone who uses science to ask and answer these types of questions. Notice how that definition does not mention bubbling beakers or fancy telescopes. These tools aren't what make someone a scientist. The thing that makes a scientist unique is the way they think. So, how does one think like a scientist? First and foremost, scientists are very curious. They are constantly asking questions, big and small, about the world around them. These questions help lead them to make discoveries, which, as we've already talked about, have impacted every part of our lives. And scientists aren't just questioning the world's mysteries either. They're also questioning and rethinking the things that we already think we know in order to further build our scientific understanding. This constant curiosity has led them to make new and improved solutions for old problems. Sometimes scientists even prove other scientists wrong about something they thought they knew. Asking questions is the way scientists help us move forward by understanding more and more about our world. So, how do scientists answer these questions? And now that I think about it, how do they come up with all of them in the first place? Well, another huge part of thinking like a scientist is making observations. When a scientist makes an observation, they use their five senses to study an object or an event closely and find specific details about them. This lets them gather evidence or proof and information. Let's try making an observation ourselves, huh? Imagine you're taking a walk on a rainy day and you spot these insects hanging out by a puddle. What observations would you make? Remember, scientists use their five senses to make observations. Pause the video here and record your observations in your guided notes. So, what did you observe? Maybe you noticed that there were three insects, or that their wings were black and green, or that they were drinking from the puddle. Those are all observations, or things you noticed using your five senses. Observations are how scientists start asking questions about our world. If a scientist sees something interesting, like a bunch of insects sitting around a puddle, then that might inspire them to start asking questions about it, like, do different kinds of weather change how insects behave? Then they can use that observation as a starting point for evidence to answer that question. They might observe that some insects move around more during warm weather, while others are very active during or after a rainstorm. So, observations are an important part of thinking like a scientist, since they help us both ask and answer questions. Here's the bad news. If your observation was something like, ooh, the color on these butterflies' wings is really pretty, or, ugh, bugs are actually kind of creepy and gross, sorry, then those aren't the kinds of observations that scientists make. Remember, we need to be able to use these observations as evidence to help us answer our scientific question. That's why when scientists make observations, they tend to keep them objective, meaning that they only focus on the facts instead of our own opinions on the subject. For example, I could think that the colors on these butterflies' wings look really cool, but you could think, they'd look better if they were yellow. Observations like that don't really help us answer most scientific questions. But we can both agree that these butterflies all have two black and green wings. That's because it's an objective observation that only focuses on the facts. Because objective observations don't change with people's opinions, they're a very useful tool for helping us gather evidence and answer scientific questions. However, observation isn't always a surefire way to answer a question. After all, what if it just didn't rain on any of the days you went out to gather information on how weather changes insect behavior? Or what if bugs in different parts of the world look and behave differently than the ones you saw? This is why scientists are always looking for new ways to collaborate with each other. Collaboration means working together. When scientists collaborate, they can share their own expertise and knowledge and even help each other gather evidence. This makes the whole asking and answering questions process work much better. In fact, most great science doesn't come from one person working alone silently in a lab. No, it comes from whole teams of people working together from all over the place. Lots of great science also relies on fieldwork to make new discoveries. Fieldwork is when scientists make observations out in the world instead of in a lab. After all, science is all around us, so it only makes sense that scientists are too. And as we know, scientists aren't just people wearing white lab coats working in quiet laboratories. They're also curious explorers, hands-on problem solvers, and much, much more. We now know that scientific thinking helps us ask and answer all sorts of questions. And that thinking like a scientist means making objective observations, gathering evidence, asking questions, and collaborating with other experts. And that means that you and I can think like a scientist too. By focusing on the facts, using our five senses, and working together, we can start discovering the answers to the world's mysteries. In fact, the questions and extension activities that go with this lesson will help you practice thinking like a scientist. Be sure to check those out to help sharpen your scientific mind. That's it for me today. Thank you for joining us, and as always, remember, science is all around us. See you next time!